हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, सो नाउ वील बिगिन विद आवर यूनिट दैट इज प्रॉफिट एंड गेन्स फ्रॉम बिजनेस एंड प्रोफेशन. दिस इज ऑल्सो वन ऑफ द हेड ऑफ योर ग्रॉस टोटल इनकम. सो दोज हु लव प्रॉफिट एंड लॉस अकाउंट विल डेफिनेटली लव दिस यूनिट एज वेल. सो लेट्स जस्ट बिगिन. अंडर दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न द मेथड टू कैलकुलेट इनकम विच इज अर्न बाय डूइंग बिजनेस प्रोफेशन एज वेल एज वोकेशन. सो वट इज बिजनेस? Business is an activity of trade, commerce, manufacture which is done by devoting human efforts which may be with or without motive to earn profit. So it means profit as well as non-profit organizations also come under this purview. Profession is an activity which is performed on the basis of educational qualification and experience. For example, your doctor, engineers, lawyers, CA, CS, all these come under your profession. Third is vocation. Vocation is an activity which is performed on the basis of skills and talent. For example, your dancer, player, painter, musicians, etc., they all will come under the category of vocation. So under this chapter, the income will be calculated by making P&L account or income on expenditure account. So you must be remembered that income and expenditure account is prepared by non-profit organizations. So both the accounts are prepared in a similar manner only as we do in accounts. However, only those incomes and expenses are recorded which are prescribed under IT Act. So under the IT Act, there are specific sections which provides a detailed purview about which expense should be debited and which expense should not be. Similarly, which income should be credited and which income should not be. So we have all the criterias and sections available with us in which we have to understand that why this particular income is credited or not, or why this particular expenses is debited or not. Okay, so the entire process is same, it's just there are few differences between the accounts and the IT Act. So first is section 45, which is method of accounting, and that we have also discussed when we did our unit 1, that is the basic terminologies. In that, when we discussed about the income under the head profits or gains from business and profession, we understood that an assessee can follow whether cash basis of accounting, and he can also follow the accrual basis of accounting. So this is the option that he has, the assessee. He can follow either of the options, that is, he can also follow the cash basis of accounting, or he can also follow the accrual or the mercantile basis of accounting. But for practical questions, until and unless the examiner specifically mentions that cash basis method is used, we will always assume that the accrual basis of accounting is used. Okay, so this is the rule, that in case examiner is not specifying about the method of accounting, you have to blindly follow that he is following the accrual basis of accounting. Okay, then next is valuation of inventory. Inventory means your stock, it means your opening stock or your closing stock, and we always we know that stock is always valued at lower of market value or the cost. So whichever the value is lower, we'll take that as the cost of your inventory. Then the next is section 29, which talks about your methods to calculate income under PGBP. This is very, very important. This is basically provides you the format for calculating the income under the PGBP. And what is the format? First, we'll write out whatever the profit is given as per the P&L account or your income and expenditure account. So we'll take that value from the respective accounts. Then we add all the expenses which should be debited, which are debited, sorry, but which are not allowed to be debited by the Income Tax Act. It means आपके अकाउंट में आपने ऑलरेडी उसको डेबिट कर दिया, आपने अपने प्रॉफिट को रिड्यूस कर दिया, बट आईटी एक्ट सेज कि नो, दिस इज नॉट अलाउड टू बी डेबिटेड. इट मींस इट शुड बी एडेड बैक टू योर प्रॉफिट्स. सिमिलरली, इनकम्स व्हिच शुड बी क्रेडिटेड बट नॉट क्रेडिटेड, इट मींस योर accounts is not specifically providing you to credit that income, but IT Act says that no, that you should credit that income. Or for example, at the time of preparation of account, some incomes are left to be credited. So if this is the case, you can just simply add those incomes to your profit. Then less expenses which should be debited but not debited. It means all the leftover expenses which are not dealt with while preparing the account, or some of the expenses which the IT Act says that should be debited but they are not debited. So that you have to subtract, because your profit in any case will be reduced in case you there are some expenses which are left to be dealt with. Then less incomes credited which are not allowed to be credited. So if there are any incomes which are credited in your account but your IT Act says that no, it should not be allowed, then you have to subtract that income from your profit, then equals to income of your PGBP. So this is very, very simple format. Okay, so this is given under section 29, in which you will just directly take the profit figure from your P&L account or from your income or expenditure account, and then you have to just deal with expenses and incomes as per the cases, because you already know that if there is an expense, then definitely the profit will come down, and if there is any income, then definitely the profit will come up. So this is the way and this is the format. Then next important thing is section 28, which talks about chargeability. So basically you have few sections which provide you that which income should be credited or which income which expenses should be debited. So section 28 basically provides you a guideline as to incomes which are taxable as incomes under PGBP. So these are the incomes which are definitely charged to tax under the head profit and gain from business or profession. It means if any of these incomes are left to be treated, then we have to definitely add those incomes to your profit account. So as per subsection 20A, as per section 28 subsection 1, profits and gains from any business or profession carried on by the assessee at any time during the previous year. So koi bhi agar usko profit or gain hua hai regarding to the business or profession or vocation also in the previous year, that should be definitely added. Gains ka meaning kya hai? This is means extra benefit or facilities which are derived by performing business or professional activity. And any business will cover both illegal and legal business. It means IT Act doesn't make a difference that if you are doing an illegal business, then your income will not be chargeable to tax. This is not the case. Whatever kind of income you are earning, you have to pay that tax to the government. Okay, so IT Act says that even if you are doing illegal business, then also you have to pay tax to us. Okay, so this is your first point. Second is any compensation or other benefit received by any person for any change in terms or termination of agency, management of an office or management of a company. So in case any compensation or any kind of payment which is given to a person, why? Because there is any modification in the terms of his contract, or in case the contract has been terminated by the company, or he was the manager and he was management se bahar nikal diya usko. It could be anything. So if any such compensation is being paid on such lines to any person, then that compensation is considered as an income and it will be added back to your profits. Then this is the third. So in this particular video, I am just discussing the highlighted ones, because these highlighted ones are the important ones from the BCom honors examination point of view. The rest, which are not highlighted ones, you can just take a note of it, and you can, these all are self-explanatory, so you can understand on your own, but I am just discussing the highlighted ones. Okay, so next important one is this, that is section 28 subsection 4, that is value of any benefit or perquisite arising from a business or the exercise of a profession. Benefits or perquisites. You have already done the salary chapter, in which we have just understood all these concepts regarding to the benefits and perquisites. So this you can just simply understand and just revise with the help of an example. That is, for example, a doctor performed operation on his patient and charged rupees 10 lakhs. The patient is highly satisfied with the service of the doctor and therefore gives him an ambulance worth rupees 3 lakhs. Now this 3 lakh is the perquisite value, right? This is a facility which is given by the patient as a honorarium for all his services that the doctor has put for him. Okay, so in this case, business income will be taken as 13 lakhs and not 10 lakhs. This 3 lakh, which is the perquisite value, that will be added back to the income. So 13 lakhs is your PGBP income and not just 10 lakhs. So always remember, in case any extra benefit or perquisite is given, then it will be added back to the income. The next is any kind of interest, salary, bonus, commission or remuneration due to or received by partner from a partnership firm. So in case partner is receiving any kind of this interest, salary, bonus, commission, remuneration, all will be added. Okay. The next important one is section 28, subsection 5, clause A. So any sum received or receivable for not carrying out any activity in relation to any business or profession, or any sum received or receivable for not sharing any know-how, patent, copyright, trademark, license, franchise or any other business or commercial right or information or technique likely to assist in the manufacture of goods or provision of services. In short, agar koi bhi aisi income mil rahi hai aapko, जो आपके बिजनेस को बोल रही है कि आप यही खत्म कर दो, या फिर आपके पास जो एक्सपर्टीज है, जो आपके पास नो हाउ है, कॉपीराइट है, पेटेंट है, वो बोल रही है कि उसको शेयर मत करो, हम आपको कुछ अमाउंट देंगे, तो ऐसा अगर कोई भी अमाउंट मिलता है, दैट विल बी एडेड बैक टू योर इनकम. देन एनी सम रिसीव्ड अंडर अ कीम एंड इंश्योरेंस पॉलिसी इंक्लूडिंग द सम ऑफ बोनस ऑन सच पॉलिसी इज टैक्सेबल एज बिजनेस इनकम if it is not taxed as salary income or income of other sources. That you will help with the that you will understand with the help of this example. Virat Kohli plays for Royal Challengers Bangalore in IPL, right? RCB, for example, has taken an insurance of rupees 50 crores for Virat Kohli under Keyman insurance policy. Keyman is basically for the important person. Okay, so usually companies also take this Keyman insurance policy for their managing directors or their CEOs, which they consider is very important for the organization. So similarly, the RCB, for example, has taken a 50 crores of key insurance policy for Virat Kohli. As per the clause, if any injury happens to Virat Kohli, RCB will get compensation from the insurance company. So for example, if any injury has happened to Virat Kohli and the amount received by the RCB and they have received the compensation amount, so this amount will be taxable as income from business and profession for RCB. क्योंकि जो भी compensation आ रहा है from the insurance company for Keyman, this compensation will be added back to the income for RCB. But in case any amount is received by Virat Kohli, then it will be taxable as income of salary if there is an employer-employee relationship, and if it is not, then it will be chargeable for him as income from other sources. Okay, so this is very important. Then next is any profit or gain arising from conversion of inventory into capital asset. This we have already done in the capital gains chapter, that in case any inventory is converted into capital asset, that particular profit, that is the fair market value of the inventory on that date, and there is an exam, there is a formula through which we calculate this profit. So this profit will be added back to the income under the head PGBP. Then any sum received or receivable in cash or in kind on account of any capital asset other than land or goodwill or financial instrument being demolished, destroyed, discarded or transferred, if the whole of the expenditure on such capital asset has been allowed as a deduction under section 35B. This we'll understand later in the chapter. In case any such amount is received for the capital asset which is demolished or destroyed or discarded or transferred. Okay, only if the whole of the expenditure has been allowed as deduction under section 35D. So this we'll learn in detail in the coming chapters. So this is it for this video. We'll do the next particular part in the next video. Okay, thank you for watching.